It's day one of the Pac-12 Women's Basketball Tournament from Michelob Ultra Arena in Las Vegas. The first game coming up at 11 is between the 5th seed Oregon State Beavers and the 12th seed Cal Golden Bears. Oregon State is coming in white hot into this game, winning 6 of their last 7 after starting just 1-5 in conference play. Now, Aaliyah Goodman has been one of the best shooters in the country for Oregon State, shooting over 52% from deep this season. Now, if Cal has any chance at getting into this game and upsetting Oregon State, they have to slow down Aaliyah Goodman and that three-point shooting ability. Now, Cal is really struggling this season, just one win overall, and they're coming off a game where they scored only 8 points in the second half against the Stanford Cardinal. Coming up at 2 in the second game is the USC Trojans, the 8th seed, and the 9th seed Arizona State Sun Devils. Now, Arizona State is coming off a huge win over their in-state rivals, Arizona, in overtime on Sunday. They're playing really well right now. They lost a couple games coming into Arizona, but that was a big momentum booster for the Sun Devils. USC is in a bit of a slump right now. The last 3 games, they've been blown out in each one, but India Rogers can light teams up. She put up 30 against Arizona State in January in a victory for the Trojans. Coming up in the third game of the matinee is the 7th seed Washington State Cougars taking on the 10th seed Utah Utes. The Cougars are a much improved team led by the Pac-12 Freshman Player of the Year, Charlize Leger-Walker. They're playing really well right now. They have huge wins this season against Arizona and UCLA. Utah has really struggled, but they have really good talent in Brennan Maxwell and Kamari Martin. And the final game is at 8 o'clock between the 6th seed Colorado Buffaloes and the 11th seed Washington Huskies. Now, Colorado has been one of the best defensive teams in the Pac-12, led by Maya Hollingshead. Washington really struggling offensively in the post-Amber Melgoza era, but they'll have to find offense to beat Colorado. Be sure to follow us on Twitter at DuckTV Sports for live updates from every tournament game and post-game highlights. From Michelob Ultra Arena with DuckTV Sports, I'm Dylan Rubenking. The first round of the Pac-12 tournament is in the books. It was an exciting 12 hours of non-stop basketball.
In the first game of 4, the 5th seed Oregon State Beavers were led by freshman phenom Talia Von Olhoffen, who scored 13 in the first half. But 12th seed Cal would not go away, as Leilani McIntosh nailed the tough buzzer-beating 3 to give the Golden Bears life. For a team that finished at the bottom of the Pac-12, the Golden Bears kept this game close down the stretch. But it was just too much Von Olhoffen, who scored 20 to lead the Beavers to a victory and a rematch against Oregon on Thursday. In Game 2, USC had a huge offensive first half, capped off by a buzzer beater from India Rogers to give the Trojans a 17-point lead at the half. The Sun Devils hung around in the second half and got some momentum from this incredible pass from Iris Bolito to Maggie Besselink on the fast break. Take a look at that one more time, just an outstanding pass. And how about one more buzzer beater? Allison Mira drains the 3 at the horn to end the third quarter, and the Trojans would hang on in the 4th to set up a duel with the number 1 seed Stanford Cardinal on Thursday. In Game 3, Utah started the game on fire from 3 against Washington State, but after that, shots just wouldn't fall for the Utes. But they fell for Bellamira Katete, who finished with 13 points and 12 rebounds for Washington State. The Utes kept this game close in the second half, but it was the Cougars pulling it out behind clutch shooting from Crystal Leger-Walker to advance to the quarterfinals to face Arizona. In the final game, Colorado rolled early in the first half, jumping out to an 8-point lead. The Huskies roared back with a huge run, sparked by Quay Miller's buzzer-beating jumper to end the first half. The Huskies came out of the gates playing with intensity and veracity on both ends of the floor. Tamia Sadler hit a dagger 3 to seal it for the Huskies, who will face the 3rd seed UCLA.
The quarterfinals begin tomorrow morning at 11 a.m. with the 5th seed Oregon State Beavers taking on their in-state rival, the 4th seed Oregon Ducks. Make sure to follow us on Twitter at DuckTV Sports for full coverage of the Pac-12 tournament quarterfinals. From Michelob Ultra Arena with DuckTV Sports, I'm Dylan Rubenking. Welcome back to Las Vegas, where the Pac-12 tournament quarterfinals are just about ready to get underway. Our first game is between the 5th seed Oregon State Beavers and the 4th seed Oregon Ducks. Now, the Beavers are playing their best basketball of the season right now, and they just defeated the Oregon Ducks in Eugene on Sunday. Now, for Oregon, if they're going to beat Oregon State, they have to utilize Sedona Prince. She scored 22 points against the Beavers on Sunday, including 18 in the first half. They have to let her get down low and take over the game. Now, the Ducks are really going to miss Tahina Paopao, who's out again with a foot injury. They're going to need Taylor Chavez and Jazz Shelley to step up, distribute the ball, and be aggressive shooting their shot. Now, for the second game is between the 8th seed USC Trojans and the number 1 seed, the Stanford Cardinal. Now, USC had a historic offensive performance yesterday against Arizona State, but Stanford has the best defense in the conference. It's going to be much more difficult for USC to get their shot against Stanford, especially with the length of freshman Cameron Brink. Now, the third game is between the 7th seed Washington State Cougars and the 2nd seed Arizona Wildcats. Now, Washington State got a huge win over Arizona in January in Pullman in overtime to put this team on the map. For the Cougars to get another upset win, they have to stop Ari McDonald, who's the Pac-12 Player of the Year. And the final game of our nightcap is at 8 o'clock between the 11th seed Washington Huskies and the 3rd seed UCLA Bruins. Now, the Bruins ran the Huskies out of their own arena last time that they played them, winning by 34 points behind their duo of Michaela Onyenwede and Charisma Osborne. If the Huskies are going to get an upset win over the Bruins in advance to the semifinals, they have to stop those two. Make sure you're following DuckTV Sports on Twitter, as I'll be live tweeting all the action today. From Michelob Ultra Arena with DuckTV Sports, I'm Dylan Rubin King. The Pac-12 quarterfinals are complete and the Final Four is set. The Oregon State Beavers, the UCLA Bruins, the Arizona Wildcats, and the Stanford Cardinal all advanced to the semifinals.
In Game 1 of the quarterfinals, the philosophy for the Oregon Ducks early was to feed Nayara Sabali and Sedona Prince, who combined for 8 of the Ducks' 10 points in the first quarter to give them an early 10-5 lead. But the Beavers wouldn't stay cold for long as they shot 50% in the second quarter to take a 5-point lead at the half. Taylor Mikesell single-handedly kept the Ducks alive, scoring 20 points in the second half. But it was just too much Beavers as they scored a Pac-12 tournament record 31 points in the third quarter and they held on to win. In Game 2, the top seed Stanford Cardinal ran the USC Trojans out of the gym. This game was a blowout from the start as the Cardinal led 23-5 after the first quarter. The Cardinal had a phenomenal offensive performance, knocking down a Pac-12 tournament record-tying 15 three-pointers, and 8 players scored at least 7 points as the Cardinal win in dominant fashion. In Game 3, Arizona got huge production from Trinity Baptiste, who scored 17 points and snagged a career-high 6 steals. The Wildcats' defense manhandled the Washington State offense, forcing the Cougars to cough up 20 turnovers in the first half, as compared to just 7 made field goals. Crystal Ledger Walker nailed a tough buzzer-beating 3 to trim the Wildcats' lead to 8 at halftime, but the Wildcats would prove to be too much for the young Cougars, prevailing in the second half 60-44. In the final game of the quarterfinals, the UCLA Bruins looked unstoppable on offense in the first quarter, but the 11th seed Washington Huskies rose to the challenge and answered with a 13-0 run in the second quarter to climb right back into the game. The Huskies finished the third quarter with momentum as Quay Miller got the steal and thread the needle to Alexis Whitfield to keep it a one-possession game going into the fourth. But the Bruins would find their stride in the fourth quarter on offense and on defense, outscoring the Huskies 16-7, forcing them to shoot just 2 of 12 from the field, and UCLA would go on to win.
Game 1 of the semifinals is between Oregon State and Stanford at 5 p.m. tomorrow night, followed by Arizona and UCLA at 8 p.m. By this time tomorrow night, we will know who will be playing in the Pac-12 Tournament Championship game. Keep following at DuckTV Sports on Twitter for complete coverage of the semifinals. From Michelob Ultra Arena with DuckTV Sports, I'm Dylan Rubin King. The Pac-12 Tournament semifinals are about to get underway as the Oregon State Beavers take on the Stanford Cardinal in our first matchup at 5 p.m. Now for Oregon State, they've really turned their season around, winning 8 of the last 9 games to get here. Now they're just 1 win away from the tournament championship game. But this is going to be their biggest test of the season, playing the best team in the conference. Now Stanford has won with their defense, but they've also won with one of the most balanced offensive attacks in the conference. They've scored 92 points yesterday without having a player score more than 15 points for them against USC. But for Oregon State, they have to be able to find their three-point shot early in the game because Stanford, they can run teams out of the building in the first half, as we saw yesterday. Now, for Oregon State, they have to get the ball down low to Taylor Jones. Same thing for Stanford, getting it to Cameron Brink early on. Those two players can really affect the game. In our second matchup, the Arizona Wildcats take on the UCLA Bruins. Arizona beat UCLA in December, but that was a long time ago. These two teams are completely different. For Arizona, their defense is what's kept them in this tournament. They've really played well, including forcing 26 turnovers against Washington State yesterday. Now, they have to put pressure on Charisma Osborne and Michaela Onyenwede, their two best players for UCLA. Now, and for Arizona, Ari McDonald has to get going. She only scored 13 points for Arizona, but she affected the game with her passing and her speed and her defense, which is where she can really hurt teams. Make sure you're following DuckTV Sports on Twitter, as I'll keep you updated throughout the day. From DuckTV Sports, I'm Dylan Rubin King. There are just two teams left in the Pac-12 Women's Basketball Tournament. the Stanford Cardinal and the UCLA Bruins. Both teams were carried by some huge performances to punch their ticket to the championship game.
In the first semifinal, the Beavers went punch for punch with the Cardinal early on, and the game was tied after the first quarter as Aaliyah Goodman scored 8 points. But Cameron Brink wanted nothing to do with the close game, as she erupted for 11 points in the second after being held scoreless in the first. She sparked a 20-3 run for the Cardinal to take an 11-point lead at halftime. The Beavers tried to claw back in the game, cutting the lead to 7 in the third, but they just could not stop Kiana Williams and Cameron Brink. They combined for 25 points in the second half, outscoring the Beavers by themselves. Brink finished with a career-high 24 points, and she led the Cardinal to their fifth straight Pac-12 tournament championship game. In the second semifinal, the UCLA Bruins jumped out to an 8-point lead at halftime, behind a 15-4 run in the second, led by Michaela Onyenwere's 10 first-half points. Arizona remained in striking distance as Ari McDonald goes off a defender's back for the layup. Charisma Osborne was 0-for-9 before hitting a clutch 3 to put the Bruins up by 10, but Ari McDonald did not want to go home early as she led a furious Wildcats comeback to cut the Bruins' lead to 2 with just over a minute left. Onyenwere said enough of that, taking it right through the defense for the dagger layup to put the Bruins up by 4 with less than a minute to go. The last effort from McDonald and the Wildcats was denied by Charisma Osborne, and the UCLA Bruins punched their ticket to their first Pac-12 tournament title game since 2016.
The Pac-12 tournament finale between the Cardinal and the Bruins will be Sunday at 5 p.m. right here in Las Vegas. You are not going to want to miss it. Keep following DuckTV Sports on Twitter for live coverage of the championship game. From Michelob Ultra Arena with DuckTV Sports, I'm Dylan Rubenking. Here we are. The Pac-12 women's basketball season ends tonight with the tournament championship game between the Stanford Cardinal and UCLA Bruins. These two teams will be meeting for the third time this season, with the Cardinal winning the first one in December on the road and the UCLA Bruins winning in Santa Cruz in January. But these two teams are completely different. The Cardinal are 10-1 all time against the Bruins in the Pac-12 tournament. But here's what the Bruins need to do to get a second win against Stanford. They have to get stops early. They have to get their defense going. If they can't get turnovers and turn them into points, it's going to be a long night for UCLA. Just ask USC and Oregon State. Now for Stanford, they just have to play their brand of basketball that they've been doing all season long. Distribute the ball on offense, find the open shooter, knock down threes, rinse, recycle, repeat. And on defense, they have to bother the ball handlers, Charisma Osborne and Onyenwere. They have to get in the passing lane, and they have to disrupt everything inside with Cameron Brink. Her length and athleticism will bother anybody she faces. It's going to be a phenomenal matchup, so make sure that you're following DuckTV Sports on Twitter for all the live updates of the championship game. From Michelob Ultra Arena with DuckTV Sports, I'm Dylan Rubenking. The Stanford Cardinal are the Pac-12 Women's Basketball Tournament champions. They defeated the UCLA Bruins 75-55 to capture their third championship in the last 5 years.
It was the Kiana Williams show in the early minutes as she drained a deep three from way back in Palo Alto to give the Cardinal a quick 6-0 lead. She was hotter than a summer day in Vegas, scoring 8 points in the first 8 minutes and knocking down both of her three-point attempts. Michaela Onyenwere did not want to go home early, hitting a triple as she scored 9 of the Bruins' 11 points in the first quarter. Now, is there anyone better than Stanford in transition? Lexi Hull got into the scoring affair with a layup on the fast break. Hull had a dozen in the first half. And Haley Jones, what can you do to stop this? She drives, stops, pops, and splashes the buzzer beater to put Stanford up 13 at the end of the first quarter. Now, Kiana Williams could have almost anything she wanted in the first half. She missed the easy layup there, and Cameron Brink is there for the putback to cap off a 17-3 Stanford run to go up by 21. The Bruins try to cut into the lead, but look at Kiana Williams doing her best Steph Curry impression, stepping back and knocking down the tough three. She had 16 in the first half. In the third quarter, Charisma Osborne had to be carried to the locker room, but she came back and knocked down the big three-pointer, and here come the Bruins within 12. The Bruins trailed by as many as 26 in the second half, and at one point they cut it down to 10. Onyenwere scored 30 for the Bruins, but it wasn't enough. The most outstanding player of the tournament, Kiana Williams, finished with 26 points as the Cardinal win their 14th conference tournament title in program history.
March is time for winning. And big players make big plays. So my teammates have confidence in me. My coaches have confidence in me. So I have to have confidence in myself.
On March 15th, the Pac-12 tournament champion Stanford Cardinal will learn of their seed in the NCAA tournament, where they are expected to be a number one seed. From Michelob Ultra Arena with DuckTV Sports, I've been Dylan Rubenking.